In linear regression, the goal is to model the relationship between one or more multiple features and a continuous target variable. In this video, you will learn about multiple linear regression in Python. We will work on housing dataset, which contains information about houses in the suburbs of Boston. There are total 506 samples and 14 columns. The goal is to predict the median value of house. Here you can see this is our data, and we have to predict the median value of house. This is the column and this is our target variable. Median value is our target variable, that is the variable that we want to predict using our independent variables. Let's import this data set in our Jupyter notebook. Let's import pandas as pd, import numpy as np. Let's read our CSV file. I'll make one object df. And now I will call the method read underscore CSV from our pandas, and I will pass my CSV file name house.csv. So we have successfully imported the CSV file in the object df. Let's explore our data set. So first I will write df.shape, and you will see we have 506 rows and 14 columns. Next we will look at df.size. The size is 7084, so it is multiplication of rows into columns. 506 into 14 is 7084. Next we will also check the dimensions, df.nd. So it is a two dimensional because we have rows and columns. Let's also look at the method sample, df.sample, and we got one sample from our data frame. We will also look at other functions such as head and tail. Let's write df.head, and these are the top 5 rows of our data frame, and these are the columns such as ci, crim, zn, indus, and so on. MADV is a target variable, that is the median value of house, and we want to predict this variable. Let's also look at the tail, df.tail. These are the bottom 5 rows of our data frame. We can also get information using the method info, df.info. And here in the output, you will see we got column names, then we have non-null count, then data type. So here the list of columns are given and also their data types. We will also get some descriptive statistics about the data set. We will write df.describe. And here in the output, you will see we got the descriptive statistics for all the continuous variable. So we have such as count, mean, standard deviation, minimum, 25%, 50%, 75%, and the maximum for each and every column. We can also look at the data types. So we will write df.dtypes. And here you will see we will get the data type of each column. For example, CRM is floor 64. Next, we will also check if there are any missing values, and we will write df.isNull.sum.sum. And here in the output, we got 0 because there are no missing values in our data set. We can also look at the unique values present in each and every column. We will write df.nUnique. And here in the output, you will see we got the unique values present in each column. So for example, let's see INDS. So in this column, there are 76 unique values. CHAS, there are 2 unique values, RAD 9, and so on. We will also get the correlation matrix. We will write df.corr. Let's execute our code. And here you will see we got the correlation matrix. This will help us when we are doing the regression analysis. And here you will see this MADV is a target variable, and we can find the correlation of independent variables with this target variable. And if you see that the first variable has negative correlation -0.38, the second is positive correlation 0.36, that is 36%, then we have -0.48, and If we look at here, you will see 0.69. So our target variable has almost 70% correlation with this variable RM. So this is the most important features in our independent variable, because our target variable has a correlation of almost 70%, that is 0.6953. Then if you look at the other variables, the correlation are not so strong. We have like 33%, minus 50%, minus 46% and so on. We will make one scatter plot to check the correlations, and we will select few columns. Let's import matplotlib. Import matplotlib. Matplotlib dot pyplot as PLD from ml extend dot plotting import scatterplot matrix. So we are going to make this scatterplot matrix using this matplotlib. Let's execute. And now I'm going to make one variable column, and in this I will pass list of columns. So I will make one list here, and for example I will pass columns such as this one, lstat, then indus, indus, then nox and rm, and our target variable medv. Now I'm going to call this scatterplot matrix, and inside this I will pass our these column names. So first I will write df and then column, because it will get the values from this data frame. Then next parameter is figure size, and I also have to type dot values because I want to get the values of these columns from this data frame df. That is why we have written df here and dot values. Next is figure size, so we will write figure size, and it is going to be 10 by 8, and then names. So in names we will have the column names. Here we will write col, and then I'll pass on parameter alpha is equal to 0.5. so this is for the color, whether we want dark or light. Next I will write plt dot tight layout, and last plt dot show. So this will make a scatter plot for us, and here in the output you can see we got the scatter plot, and here you will see the scatter plot. If you look at the scatter plot, you will see that here we have the different independent variables, and here we have the target variable MADV. And if you look at the correlation between the MADV and RM, you will see it is there is a good correlation. We have seen above the correlation between RM, this one, and MADV is 0.69%, and here also you will see the correlation is going in the positive direction. Here you will see that. So the correlation between these two variables, that is RM and MADV, is good, almost 70%. Now we are going to make the correlation heat map. Let's make, first we will import from ml extend dot plotting import heat map. Now I'll make one variable, and in this I will save the correlation np dot correlation coefficient. So from numpy I am calling this method correlation coefficient, and I want to get the correlation coefficient of df of columns, that is I want to get the correlation coefficient of these columns, That is why I am providing here df of column dot values, and then I will transpose is, so I will type t. Next I will make one more variable hm, and in this I will save the heat map, and inside this I will pass our correlation coefficient which are saved in this variable cm. Next I will write row names, so our row names are going to be column names, so I will write col columns, and then column names will also be columns, so I will write cl. Next plt dot show, and we got error here, list of ignore attribute values. So here I have to put one bracket here. Now I will run this again, and here you will see we got the correlation matrix here. So if you see here, the correlation with our target variable MADV, this RM we have 0.7, that is 70% correlation. With NMX we have -43%, with INDUS we have -48%, and with LSTAT we have -74%. So we are having a good correlation with this variable RM, that is 70%. Next we will split our data frame into X and Y. I'll make one variable X, and now I will call our data frame df.iloc. In X we will save all the independent variables, so I will type colon. Colon means I want all the rows, comma, colon, -1. -1 means I want all the columns except the last column, because the last column is our target variable and we don't want to save that in our variable X. Next I will make Y, df.iloc. I want all the rows, and this time I just want the last column, so I will type -1, because this will contain our independent variable or the target variable MADV. Let's execute our code. We can check the shape of X and Y. I'll write X dot shape. So in X we have 506 rows and 13 columns. Y dot shape. In Y we have only target variables, so we have 506 rows. Now we are going to split the data set into train and test. So I will import from sklearn dot model selection, import train test split. Now I'm going to make variables such as xtrain, xtest, ytrain, ytest, and I will call this train test split. Inside this I will pass our data frame x and y, and I will pass one parameter random state. And you can put any number here, let's say 1. You can put any number here, but if you want your result to be same as mine, then you have to put 1 here. Let's execute our code. So we have split the dataset into training and testing. Now let's import the linear regression from sklearn dot linear model, import linear regression. Now I'm going to make an object of this class linear regression and save in lr. Lr is equal to, we will call this linear regression class, and now I'm going to fit this on our xtrain and ytrain. So I will write lr dot fit on xtrain and ytrain, xtrain and ytrain. Let's execute our code. So we have fit the linear regression on our xtrain and ytrain. Next we are going to make prediction and save it in a new variable. I'll make one variable y underscore pred, and from lr I will call the method predict, and we want to make predictions on xtest, so I will type xtest here. Let's look at some predictions, so I will write y underscore pred. And here you will see in the output, these are the predicted values for our target variable MADV. Now we are going to print this slope and intercept from our regression model. So I will write print. First we will print the slope. Print slope percent dot 2f. percent LR dot, and to print slope we have to call coefficient underscore and index number which is 0. So our slope is negative minus 0.1. Next we will print the intercept. Print intercept f percent, and print intercept is present in this method intercept underscore. Let's execute our code. So our intercept is 45.9. now let's import the evaluation matrix to check the accuracy of our model. From sklearn dot matrix we will import mean square error or MSE. So we will import this and I will call this mean square error. Now I'm going to pass our y test and I will compare it with the y pred. In the output you can see the mean square error is 21.89, which is good because the error should be as low as possible. We can also calculate the RMSE, and that is root mean square error. RMSE is nothing but the square root of mean square error. So I will call from numpy sqrt. So this is a method from numpy, square root method, and inside this I will just copy this code from here and paste it to get the RMSE. So our RMSE is 4.67. it is the square root of mean square error. We can also get the r square. So I will write print r square percentage dot 2f. 2f means we want the result to be in two digits, that is why we are writing 2f everywhere. Percentage lr dot score, and here we will pass x test and y test, and our r square is 0.78%, which is good. R square should be as close to 100. So it is very close to 100. We have 78, and the error should be as low as possible. It should be as close to 0, and you will see here that it is 21 and 4. So the error are also quite good. So this is how you can develop your linear regression model in Python. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.